I'm late, man. I'm late. Once again, I'm late. I'm tardy. But it's all good, man. It don't matter when I get the video up, as long as I get the vid up, right? Right? I think so. What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, Mike Rich, man. What's happening with y'all today? I hope everybody having a blessed day today, man. Today, I'm going to do a quick, fast unboxing of a sneaker that everybody already did their videos on already. It is what it is, man. Like I said, as long as I get the video up, as long as I bring the video to the people, it doesn't matter. Don't it seem like when you pinch your hand together like that, don't it seem like you're saying something important? As long as I bring the video, it doesn't matter. As long as you get the content, as long as you get the vid, you feel me? Anyway, man, late pickup. Actually, it's not late pickup. Ordered off Sneakers app. It arrived on, well, Monday was a holiday, so I used to get my stuff Wednesday. Did it come Wednesday? What's today? No, it came yesterday. It came Thursday. So, here we go. Once again, with the Pro Theft box going on. Just do it. Nike swooshes and whatnots and goings on. But they still got that Nike tape, man, so your boy can open this box with these hands. Gotta do it. Uh-oh. Started off weak, man. Come on, Rich. Did they tape it? I mean, wait a minute. Did they glue it, too? Hold up. So, Nike, I'm sorry, but that little glue, I'm going to have to tear it up. That glue that y'all put on it, it ain't going to stop nobody from stealing it. I don't know if you're trying to stop somebody from peeking in on it or whatever. They ain't gonna stop nobody from stealing it though. And the question is this shoe, question for this shoe is, did I impulse buy? Did I not need this shoe? Well, I know I impulse buy. It was definitely an impulse buy because I didn't plan on buying these at all whatsoever. I was going after the Jordan 1 LA to Chicago's, and I ended up buying these because I took an L on a LA to Chicago joint, so I have to do an unsure thumbnail. Yeah, I have to be unsure because I'm unsure if I'm actually going to be keeping the shoe. It was an impulse buy, so I have no idea whatsoever if I'm going to keep this sneaker. Y'all probably already know what it is, but anyway, let's go ahead and get into it real quick. Let's go ahead and get into it without further ado. As you can see, you probably can't see that. You have that SB, I guess, paper. That's what that is. Is that SB paper? I don't know. Y'all tell me. Let's see. I see them laces. You can see the laces through the bag. You know what I'm saying? So let's see what this thing looks like in hand and splackacow, as Martin Lawrence would say. Splackacow. The the Jordan 1 Paris? Wait a minute. What is it? Is it NY to Paris? I don't know. I think that's NY to Paris. SB guy. Now, I'm a fan of Jordan 1s, not a fan of SBs. This is the first thing I've ever owned that has actual SB on. I had a couple of SBs, but I got them for other people or whatever. This is the only one I've ever owned that actually has SB on it to keep or whatever. And these are actually dope, though, bro. I ain't even gonna count. These are clean, man. These are clean. That doesn't mean I'm keeping them, because I actually did find a way. The paper is dope, too. I like that. Look like wood grain or something. Anyway, I actually did come up on, shout out to my guy, man. I'm going to shout him out when I get the shoe. But actually did come up on the LA to Chicago joints. And when I see those in hand, I might make my real decision on whether I'm going to keep these guys or not. But that don't mean they don't deserve a bow. That don't mean they don't deserve a bang. Yeah. Bow. The Air Jordan 1 NY. To Paris? I don't have my phone in here. I think that's what it is. I don't know why I keep thinking that's wrong for some reason. Is that right, y'all? Is that right? Am I correct in that assessment? Is that what they call? I know the other ones are LA to Chicago. I think these are NY to Paris. And I don't even know the story behind them. I didn't do my research. I didn't read up on it. And like rubbing on these shoes right now, bro, I have no idea. I mean, you cannot tell that this paint comes off. I thought it was going to feel kind of like a different texture. It just feel like leather. You really can't tell this. How do you remove the paint? I mean, somebody was saying like nail polish remover. Let me get a little bit more light right there. Somebody was saying like nail polish remover or something like that. I don't know. And it sometimes, looking at some of the pairs that people are starting to get the paint off of these right here, it looked like it's not that easy to do. It's like they really having to rub the paint off of these guys. So I don't know if it's supposed to, I mean, originally, are you supposed to let it do that over time of rocking this shoe? Or do you supposed to go ahead and just say, I'm going to rip this paint off myself? Because I'm telling you, bro, as I rub my hands on this, I'm like, how you going to get that off, Shawty? I mean, you can see it a little bit up here where it look like it's going to come out. But I seen a couple of pictures that, like, when I first bought the shoe, probably like 20 minutes after I bought it, I was like, bro, I ain't keeping no, man. I'm just going to try to find a way to get the LA joints. But I started seeing pictures on IG, man. And depending on how you do it, like this swoosh, y'all seen pictures. The swoosh turned like a bright pink. It's like the same color as the insole. That's the way, that's what color the swoosh turns. And I think this upper, everything that's black turns that bright color. And I think everything that's gray turns like a pinkish color, if I'm not mistaken. And it's supposed to be the colors that's in the laces. So we got like a peach. It ain't even really pink. It's like a peachish kind of color lace. You got this bright magenta, fuchsia, pink, whatever you want to call that. And then you have the regular gray laces, which would, that's how you would rock it, I guess, if you just keep an original color, super boring like that. But I don't know, man, like, I just see people do lace switch-ups and do different stuff with the paint and stuff like that, and it make the shoe look fine, so it kind of make me tempted to keep it. Plus, I think one of the dopest things about this shoe, especially before you even change the paint on the shoe, is the lines. You can see the lines right here, like the creases behind, like the leather, where the leather panels are, even on the swoosh, all that. Behind each panel, stitched panel right here, you can see like the lines, like a different colors, like the light, kind of like peach color. You know what I'm saying? I think that looked dope anyway. I think that's like one of those SB dunk type of things that they got going on with it. But I don't know, man. Comment below and tell me if you think this was a good pickup. Should I keep them? Should I just go ahead and be like, you know what? Because I mean, I think they fire. I ain't gonna lie to you, but I just got so many Jordan 1s. Like, originally, even with this like barren Jordan 1 kind of colorway, I would have just kept these. Like, years ago, I would have just, it wouldn't even be no question. Because it's a dope shoe, I would have kept it. I think they even look good with the original black laces in them. They're a little fine. But it's just like, so, if you see this wall, these are just Jordan 1s that's in the case. Well, you probably can't even see all of them. So it's like 15 of them just in the cases right there. Then I got a whole nother two stacks all the way to the ceiling of Jordan 1s right here. And it made me be like, bruh, do I need to keep getting these Jordan 1s? Especially when they release on like the same day, like when I did the pine greens and the court purples, boom, two Jordan 1s that day. These right here, and then on the way, I got the LAs, two Jordan 1s, you know what I'm saying? I got Spider-Mans, they look like Chicago's as well. You know what I'm saying? If you want to shoot it, just look like Chicago. I might keep the Lakers joints, just the original color. And I seen a couple of people, like Foma Simpson, he did his LA's real dope, the way he just mixed it up and just made it look so like a vintage kind of custom a little bit by showing a little paint here and there. And I seen a couple of people do these. It's a couple of pictures on IG, like I said, that these look real fine. But I already got, like, look at this, man. I already got these. And that was just a slick excuse to go ahead and pull these out. But do I really need to strip down my LA's when I get them? Because I got the Chicago's, I got these, I got Spider-Man's, you know what I'm saying? Anything that has that kind of Chicago look. Is it just me, or does every time I see, what's this guy named J. Cole, he got a pair of these on with some long shorts or something, or some shorts, I don't know. But it seems like every time I see J. Cole, he got a pair of these guys on. He might got like a few of them. I need another pair of these. These were super limited, and the resale is ridiculous on this shoe. So I think anything that reminds anybody of a Chicago Jordan 1, they going after it. Like the Chicago Jordan 1 Lowe's even skyrocketing in resale now. When they first came out, they collected their thick dust tan on shelves, you feel me? But anyway, man. I love this shoe, bro. One of my favorites, man. The Chicago is just, it's so original. I got the black toes. It's just Jordan 1s, man. Do I need this many Jordan 1s? That's the question. So the question is, will I return these? And I'll give y'all an update when I think about it for a couple of days. It's going to be after I get my LAs in. It's going to be after probably a couple more pickups. And I'm just sitting there seeing what Jordan 1s might come out. Do I want to take these back and get some more better Jordan 1s that might release? I don't know. Because, like I said, so many Jordan 1s been releasing. I actually passed on a lot of Jordan 1s. It's just so many Jordan 1s dropping. Like, and what's going on with the Shattered Backboards? Like, I saw the Shattered Backboard Jordan 1 Lows that they were going to do, kind of in the SB, you know, whatever, and I plan on copying those. And they talking about all patent leather, or it might not be all patent leather. It might be regular leather. Who knows, man? So, anyway, I'm sorry for rambling so much in this video. Y'all know how I get when I get to talking, but I just be like, blah, 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 blah. You feel me? But what y'all think about these, man? Y'all comment below and tell me, should I keep them? Should I take them back? I like the little SB. This is like my first shoe that got like the actual SB on the Nike logo right there. So I don't know, man. I might. Still got that dope Jordan 1 smell. I love that smell, man. I might keep them, though. I don't know. I got Chicago's. Got LA's on the way. Got these right here. I don't know. Y'all comment below and let me know what would y'all do in this situation. Is this just a consolation prize? Is this just an impulse? Well, I know it's an impulse buy, but did I just get these because I didn't get the LA's at first? I think that's the reason, man. I probably originally wouldn't have copped these, but more I'm seeing pictures, it's just like, it's an addiction, man. When you lay in the sneakers, bro, you just be like, man, them look kind of fire. I don't know if I want to get rid of them all. You feel me? But anyway, man, that's this video. Just want to do this quick unboxing. Of course, I won't be doing no paint tutorial with it right now. Of course, I won't be doing no on feet of it right now because I'm still undecided on what the outcome, what the fate is for this sneaker in my collection, man. You feel me? A lot of laces, though. The different color laces, very dope. Anyway, it's been your boy Mike Rich. I appreciate y'all for watching this video. Of course, I will do the unboxing when I get the other pair. And of course, I got more pickups. I got pickups, early pickups, delayed wins, all kind of stuff coming, man. So y'all keep staying tuned to your boy channel. More vlogs are coming too. I know y'all missed the vlogs, and I already got two pair of the Raptor 7s. They come out this weekend. I mean, not Raptors. I keep calling them Raptors. The Ray Allen 7s. They come out this weekend, so I probably won't do a pickup vlog, but I probably will sneak in some kind of vlogish kind of material going on. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, it's been your boy Mike Rich. I hit the thumbs up, like, subscribe, and all that good stuff. Hit the notification bell so you can become a part of Rich Nation. Staying all the way up to the moon on them. 300K, where you at? Subscribe, man. We trying to hit that 300K, you feel me? And keep watching my video, cause that's what I'm here for. Gone. Mike, Rich, no hype, just kicks. Jordan, 6, 8 and 9, fit. Hottest, trends, clank, clank, cleanse. Bless, yes, I'm Rich, M, I K E, you know me. OG, only, real, no phony. ATL, homie. Shot my boy T, YFHB, I see mint freeze on my free throw line three. Mike, Rich, no hype, just kicks. Mike, Rich, no hype, just kicks. Mike, Rich, no hype, just kicks. Jordan 6 in my 8 and 9.